Welcome everyone to the epic, awesome show, Anime Podcast number 176. And today we're going to be looking at a lot of different stuff here, so let's kind of just jump into it here. And so the first thing we're going to talk about here on the podcast here is talk a little bit about some of the anime that have come out so far this season. There have been a few things that, I'm just going to change this up a little bit here. There have been a few animes that have come out that I've really, truly, really liked. Ancient Magnus Bride absolutely has been a phenomenal series. If you guys have not checked it out yet, it definitely a series that, if you guys have not checked it out yet, definitely check it out because it's really worth the, it's really darn good. The first episode alone is absolutely fantastic. Granted, I haven't really been able to really watch too much of it with, you know, working a lot and doing a lot of other stuff here because working on a bunch of other stuff for the YouTube channel and everything else. And that's I'm about ready to just smack this up right now. I'm about to do this real quick. That way, now I'm not going to get it anymore. Here we go. So with that being said, as I said before, Ancient Magnus Bride is absolutely a phenomenal series. If you guys have not yet seen it yet, it's really good. So definitely one of my favorites there. One of my least favorites so far this season. I don't know. I don't really know if I have a really least favorite so far. Black Clover, I think, is one of those series that I think is just kind of cliche. And we've seen it a million times before. Granted, I've watched the first couple episodes of it. And yeah, it's okay. It's nothing, you know, spectacular. I don't see anything that's really, really, really good where it's like, oh my goodness, it's amazing. It's so amazingly good. Ah! No, I mean, I really don't see that with Black Clover. Granted, my favorite so far has been Ancient Magnus Bride. Anime Guitarist has been really good. Surprisingly, that I actually kind of really enjoyed that. Watching the first episode, that was a lot of fun. So with that being said, I noticed the fact that we've always been talking a lot about anime and the fact that it's been doing really well as of late. And one of the best ways to talk about this is from anime. Basically, the anime industry takes in a record 2.0 trillion yen in 2016. So now, of course, this is according to the Association of Japanese Animations, the AJA, published its anime industry report for 2017, which examines industry trends from 2016 on Tuesday. Now, the report confirms like previous reports that the total market value of anime industry in 2016 was a record 2.9 trillion yen, which is about $17.5 billion U.S. dollars, and up about 9% from 2016's 1.83 trillion yen. This continues the industry's upward trend. The total market value in 2014 was up 10% from 2013, and in 2015 was up 12% from 2014. So it's actually a really good indication of where anime is right now, where the industry is at right now. And I would say it's doing really well with stuff like Your Name came out recently. That was really good. It's out on DVD now, and I think it's done really well on DVD. Granted, I bought it, and you know, it's like I had to have it as soon as it came out and got the exact same day. I mean, I had to work that day, but dang it, it was totally worth it having to work on that day. So Your Name was also like, it's one of those things that now also, because talking about Your Name here, the report also cites the success of Your Name film as a factor for the growth, but also indicates that the industry has already been seeing record revenues even before the film. The report notes that the film has earned 16.4 billion yen, which is about $144 million in the Japanese box office. So that's really darn good. So it's not needless to say, like, not nearly as much there. When you're looking at growth and you know, all these different stuff here, it's really good trend to see the fact that what we've been getting. Like, for instance, I kind of want to go over the animes that have been really good so far this season. Kind of going a little bit over the trend of what's really been going on, basically what we've been getting. So let's kind of look at the – so we want to go look at the winner. The winner was pretty much – is pretty much a good indicator of where we stand at right now. Now, granted, Masamune Kun no Revenge, I believe that was a really good series. Little Witch Academia was really good. I really hate the fact that this is all in Japanese. I'm looking off of Anichart right now. I mean, you got Dragon Maid, which is really, I really enjoyed that. there's also another one here that it would help if I could actually speak. This would be great. Yujo's Senki, basically the one where all of the girls are in high school, I want to say, or it's middle school or whatever it is. Demi-chan wa Keta, yeah, Keta Ari. I hate the fact that I have to deal with these names. Chaos Child was okay. Tales of Ziri the Axe 2 was really good. Fuka was another one that was really good. Akiba's Trip, the animation was darn freaking good. I mean, you have Gintama, that's not anything unusual there. Chain Chronicle, that was okay. It was nothing spectacular with that one. Super Lovers 2 came out, which, granted, I was never a big fan of that, though. I mean, those are just a few series, though, that came out in the beginning of the first season alone. So that was pretty much about, what, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 anime that I really, 7 anime that I really, truly, really liked. Now, Handshakers, I think, was one of the worst animes from the season, just because it was really bad. It was, like, it wasn't terrible, as in the normal terrible of, oh, my goodness, it was so good. Like, it was, like, the writing and everything was so terrible. No, it was just the animation on it was just, like, inconsistent and just weird and just, ugh, just did not work at all. Now we go into the spring anime. Now, granted, a lot of this year, I really haven't watched a lot of stuff here. But you have My Hero Academia 2, Season 2. Season 2 of Attack on Titan, Season 2. Eromanga Sensei. Recreators. It was also a really good, phenomenal series from what I saw of it. I know it's available on a lot of this stuff, because a lot of this really good stuff is around to pick up girls in the dungeon. Sword Toria is really darn good too as well, and I really enjoyed that for what I got to see of it, because it's like, granted, I get to go back into the universe of Is It Wrong to Pick Up Girls in a Dungeon, and granted, I just love it. Clockwork Planet, I don't think was that terrible. Wasn't really that fantastic, but Soccer Quest, surprisingly, I was really surprised by Soccer Quest that, you know, I kind of was actually kind of enjoying it after, even though the main lead is annoying, but it gets, you do definitely get away with it. Owaru Salesman New is actually a really darn good one as well. If you guys have not yet to be able to check that out yet, definitely check it out. It's The Laughing Salesman is the actual English title of it, and it's available on Crunchyroll, and it's surprisingly really good. And it's more of the fact that it's like the Twilight Zone. So if you're a big fan of the Twilight Zone, I think you'll definitely enjoy that, and definitely, you know. And there, I think that's pretty much it. Yu-Gi-Oh! V-Reigns came out. That didn't seem anything, you know, too ecstatic for me, but I'm just kind of like to see here what else there was here. But yeah, that's pretty much it. So I would say that was the weakest one was, I think, was this season. Because most of the Recreators, I think, is definitely going to be a lot of people's maybe top pick, because it's really darn good. I still got to finish it, but I may wind up doing that here in a little bit. Just definitely finishing that. Finishing a few seasons up, because it's like, granted, there's a lot of stuff in this year that I've not been able to watch. And I really want to take a look at everything together and see, you know, where anime is in a nutshell. Now, granted, now this last season had Gamers, which was really darn good. If you guys have not seen it yet, definitely see it. Fate Apocrypha, which is actually available on Netflix right now, has come out on Netflix. So definitely, if you guys have not seen that yet, I've yet to watch it yet. The other one is my girlfriend. My first girlfriend is a gal. I believe that's the English title of it. And that one's surprisingly, I kind of really like that series. Now, granted, is it anything spectacular? No, definitely not. I can't remember the name of this, the English title of this one. It's basically where the every week, basically every day. Every day the restaurant's in a new place. There's that one right there, which is actually pretty darn good. It's in a new realm, basically, and every single time it's in there. So that's actually really cool. 18 If, surprisingly, really works really well. Now, granted, what 18 If does, what exactly, I can't think of the name of that series, is, Flip Flappers. No, not Flip Flappers. I believe it was in Winters. Where was that? It was the one that I just can't stand it. I'm looking for it right now. No, it's not on this. It's in the... That's right, it's in the spring. I'm good about that. Because, like, I'm trying to figure out where was that, the one that I talked about. And it's kind of like, it's one of those things where it's like, it's kind of eh. But I believe it's part of the winter one. I could be wrong. It may have been part of the summer lineup. I didn't think it was part of that summer lineup, but I could be wrong. Could be part of the spring, the winter lineup here. Because, it's like, I know I'd seen it. I know I just talked about it, too. And it's like, drives me nuts, actually. Handshakers. That's what it was. Handshakers. Basically, the series I was talking about here is summer. And it was in the summer here. Because right now we're in fall. Which one was it now? Going through here. 18F, okay, that's what we're talking about. 18F is way better, is pretty much what Handshakers was trying to do, but 18F does it so much better because it utilizes the I believe it doesn't actually use any, it uses some, I know it uses some CG for that realism because they're in these sleeping, they're in the dream world and everything, so it's just really kind of interesting. I love the style of this series. I've yet to finish that one up either. There's a lot of series that I've yet to finish just because it's like, you know, you start a series, then you just want to continue on. Yeah, other stuff that just pop in and, you know, just trying to get other stuff done. And it's just, it's an insane time. But I mean, as you can tell though, it's like this last season was really darn good. I mean, there was some pretty good darn series. I think there was at least three or four series that I could easily say, yeah, I enjoyed watching it. Granted, did I finish it? No, it's no fault of the anime itself. It's mostly my own fault for having just so much to do. And then we go on to the fall series, which the fall season has Ancient Magnus Bride, Black Clover. I know a lot of people are really liking that one. The third season of Food Wars, because that's, you know, everyone's favorite series right there. I'm trying to think of any other series, really. Oh, Hamoto Haru-chan is... I forgot about that second season of Hamoto Haru... Hamoto Haru-chan. Wow, I can't even pronounce stuff today. This is not going well. This is not going well. All right. Yeah, Evil or Live, I would say is relatively interesting. From this season alone, I don't know how strong the season is. I mean, it's got some definitely some interesting animes in this season alone. The strongest, I would say one of the strongest animes from this season is Ancient Magnus Bride. And Recreators, I think, is another one that's really darn good from what I have actually seen. Now, granted, if there's something I'm missing, let me know in the comments below here, because I want to know exactly, you know, what I might be actually missing here, what series is I may be missing for the sure fact of, okay, what are some of your guys' favorite series? I kind of want to know, like, what are some series that you would actually recommend? Now, I know there's a lot of really good... sorry about that, guys. Woo. Like, I want to know, what are some of your guys' favorites from this season alone? Now, because I kind of really want to know, like, what exactly everyone's been listening to. Everybody's been watching. I think it's going to be a really fun time to see where we're at as a, you know, just not just as fans, but as, you know, just as everything together. It'll be really cool to see. And I know there's a lot of stuff here that, sorry about that. I'm just looking at certain things here that I had gotten stuff ready for a while ago, and it's just kind of like not going well for me. Also, as well, too, I might as well let you guys know as well, on High Dive, Haiku. Yeah. High Dive now has the English dub for Haiku, is either available now or it's coming available. So if you guys want to check that out, definitely check it out. It's got a really great cast in there. One of the main leads in there is Bryson Bogus. We've done an interview with him as well. During Anime Austin was when we were able to do that interview. And absolutely amazing guy. If you guys have not yet checked out anything he's been in, he's been in Is It Wrong to Pick Up Girls in a Dungeon, and he's also been in My Love Story. He's also been in, as I said, Haiku, the main lead for that as well. So if you guys have yet to check that out, the dub, I believe, will be available. I believe it's available now. I'm not 100% sure on that yet. I know it's coming soon. I just don't know if it's available now or not. But talking about some of the best people here going in here is Funimation Entertainment announced that the main English dub cast for the Ancient Magnus Bride on Tuesday. So basically, this has been a dub. This has been like available for a while now, and I know I'm really behind on the times and everything else, but it basically has Danny Chambers, Brian Mathis. I think both of these guys, I'm not exactly really big on these two names either, but Tia Ballard is in there as well, Rachel Glass, and Garrett Storm as well. Now, Kyle Phillips is directing the dub with ADR engineer Jeremy Woods and scriptwriter Bonnie Clickenbeard and mixing engineer Nathaniel Harrison. So I would say it's a very interesting cast. Granted, the two there, Brian Mathis and Danny Chambers, I'm actually not exactly really familiar with them. So I'm actually going to look this up real quick, because I think they might be relatively new-ish. Yeah. Okay, so she is Danny Chambers is very, very new. She's been in A Centaur's Life, Hina Logic from Luck and Logic, and Morris Monokian. So she's very new to the Funimation family, so that's actually really cool. So I've actually not yet heard her in anything yet, which I'm assuming is going to be really darn good. It's just surprising that they had one of the people said that's just not been in that much. The other one, though... Brian Mathis has been in a ton. He's just been in a lot as of late. So Soul Eater. So he's been there for a while with Spice and Wolf, Strike Witches 2. Yeah, so he's been in there for a while. He's been in Gangsta, Fairy Tale. Basically, Fairy Tale 2 season TV, yeah, 2014, Fairy Tale the movie, you know, Brotherhood and Sacred Star of Milos. So he's been in there for a while. I mean, granted, he wasn't there. I don't think he was there for Full Metal, but it does show me exactly, you know, where he's been at for most of the stuff there. So I think it's actually really cool to see that. He's been in Black Clover, Black Butler. Yeah. I just haven't heard him too much in anything. I think he probably does. I think he does a lot more stuff behind the scenes stuff, I think. He's just a lot of the – I think he's just mostly a lot of bit characters, which is not bad at all. It's just that fact that, you know, it's like I'm really interested to see, you know, how well this dub does. I mean, I'm expecting the dub to be really darn good because, you know, it's like I have a certain expectation, which I know it came out the 7th. So it's been out for a while. It's been actually been out on the 30th. So it came out on the 30th. So that was what? About almost 2 weeks ago at this point? Oh, sheesh. Yeah, no, I'm sheeshing myself here. This is mostly me sheeshing me here. And the one thing, too, is that with this podcast, I'm trying to keep this going as quickly as we can, as much as we can. Even if, like, you know, Scotty's not available to do the podcast, we're going to get this podcast out for you guys so you guys can keep up to date, you know, with what exactly is going on with the industry, with the anime, you know, with anime itself in an absolute nutshell. So the one thing is, though, is that another thing, too. Okay, so I actually do have a question for you guys as well, because we are going to be going to Anime North Texas this year, and we're going there as press and what we normally do. So if you guys are going to be at Anime North Texas this year in Dallas, Texas, which is from the 17th, I believe it's from the 17th through the 19th. So it goes from that Friday. It goes from that Friday to Friday to Sunday. So if you guys have not yet checked it out, a lot of people who are going to be there, we're going to be doing a ton of interviews there as well with who else is going to be there is Christopher Wakeup, Zach Aguilar, Genevieve Simmons, Juliet Simmons, Caleb Hiles, Aaron Roberts, Chris Rager, Josh Martin, Allison Lowry, D. Rich, and Mick Cubed. So there's a lot of they got a lot of guests there, which is actually really darn cool to see the fact that the giveaways, AMV contest, basically the Taku Lounge, gaming room, art show. They have a lot of stuff going on in here, which I'm really hoping there's going to be a ton of really cool stuff here. I'm hoping to see a lot of really cool people at this convention. I mean, these are just some really cool names that they have here at this con in Dallas. So we're going to be there. We're going to be all over the place. So if you see us there, definitely come say hi, you know. Don't feel free to come say hi, you know, and, you know, if you want to talk or whatever. Because, hey, we're here to help you guys out. And, you know, we're here to give you guys as much information as possible for anime conventions. Now, with Anime North Texas, we're also going to be doing got the camcorder as well. And so that means we're going to be doing a lot of things live as well. So from this con as well, from next week's con, we're also going to be working on getting panels as well. So some of the panels that we might be able to get now, granted, we're going to be opening ceremonies. That's a given. Guests, I think that's the one of the main things is I want to do is I want to get guest panels. If there's a certain guest panel that you guys want to see, let me know in the comments below. Let me know whether or not you want to see, you know, it's just something about from Zach Aguilar or what you really want to see on the channel, because I'm going to try to do basically a big thing, a huge thing for this convention, and basically have a too long didn't read version of Anime North Texas, and then basically kind of giving you the highlights and lowlights of the con. Mostly the highlights, not the lowlights, but you know what I mean. And just different things about, you know, hopefully this con is going to be really good, and I'm looking forward to it. I think it's going to be a lot of fun. Usually most cons are a ton of fun. So let's see where we at with time here. Do we have time? This is the question here. Yes, we have time. Yeah. We do have time. We have plenty of time. Goody, 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 goody. Also coming in December as well, we are in full swing working on Anisember. So I know there's a lot of stuff that hasn't been happening. Kind of giving you guys a little bit of heads up here. Anisember is going to take up a lot of time. So first looks might get, I don't know if I'm going to be able to get much up on the YouTube channel. Definitely I'm going to be working on getting the anything from Anime North Texas up within the next month. So that's going to be, you know, giving us some time as well. If there's another con you guys want us to go to, let us know in the comments below as well, because I would love to go to another convention. You know, what con that you guys want to see us try to cover, whether it be Anime Expo or one of the bigger cons, or whether it's a smaller con or a bigger con, because we want to help you guys get the front row seat to the con itself, because I think that would be a really cool thing to be able to live stream a con. Now, granted, to live stream every single panel, I would say is impossible to do right now. Currently, that's where I would love to get at, to the point where we're live streaming every single panel that's going on at a certain convention. That would be really cool. Now, granted, that would have to be, you know, if it's 18 plus, it's obviously you just can't, you can't record it. If it's like certain things that you just can't do, you have to be at the con for it. It kind of sucks, but whatever. As I said, what do you guys want to see us do more of the con? Do you just want pictures? Do you want, you know, more video aspect of it? Because I'm trying to do more and more video for it, just for you guys, so you guys can, you know, enjoy everything together and really enjoy these conventions. And hopefully you're enjoying our coverage of the interviews, basically the panels that we're going to be doing. So I think those are going to be a lot of fun. And I think it's going to be lots and lots of fun for us to just be able to do these panels and everything else. And I'm really repeating myself right now. So with that being said, guys, what can I do for love? With that being said, guys, I don't really think I have too. I don't think I have too much to really add to this week, just because of the fact that we're kind of coming back from the, basically coming from our lovely, you know, hiatus, trying to figure out how exactly we're going to do different things here. Basically, this is kind of just an update to let you know as well. Also, Crunchyroll is going to be screening the first four Black Clover episodes in theaters. Now, granted, I believe this is just the sub version of this show and not the dub. So it'll screen the first four Black Clover episodes and tickets go on sale November 15th. So basically theaters 6th, 9th, and 10th. So more than likely, if you're in a big area, more than likely you'll be able to watch it. I don't know why they're doing this. They're doing it basically as a movie night. And to be honest with you, it just doesn't make any sense to me why they're doing this. I mean, I know it's supposed to be this big, huge anime because it's from the same studio that brought you Naruto. And yeah, I mean, what's so great about Black Clover is it's kind of the same thing as Naruto in a way, where basically this guy just, you know, he just wants to become the best person here. And obviously, you know, he gets the Black Clover. He also gets the same, you know, thing with the Black Clover. He's able to actually use magic. And I kind of go, okay. I mean, it's okay. It's nothing fantastic, but it's just kind of okay. As I said, I really don't have anything. Also, as well, there are a few animes, you know, in consideration for the Oscars. Now, granted, more than likely, these probably aren't going to get anywhere as well, because if so, some of the anime that are there for okay, so some of them that basically list are 26 films that have been submitted for consideration of the animated feature film category of the 90th Academy Awards. Which actually include, I believe this is all the, yeah, this is a spoiler list here, which includes Koichi's In This Corner of the World, Studioponics, Mary and the Witch's Flower, Napping Princess, A Silent Voice, and Sword Art Online, the movie Ordinal Scale. Now, so the submitted for the award, a maximum of 5 films from the list will receive a nomination. So, what are they going up against? I would say A Silent Voice is probably going to be the one that could actually even have a chance at it. And it's like, it's one of those films, too, A Silent Voice. I believe A Silent Voice has yet to be re... I don't know if they're still doing that, I don't remember when the show times were for The Silent Voice, whether it was, I forget, like, whether or not it was, yeah, because it was, like, October 20th. It was a really weird time. And I don't believe there was any other show times available from what I could tell from, oh, wow, whatever. Ask me later, don't care. So I'm just trying to figure out certain things here. But I would say out of the anime that's actually out there right now, I'd say Silent Voice is probably the best one right there, because I've heard really good things about that series. Now, here are some other ones that are, you know, nominated with them as well. So we have The Big Bad Fox and Other Tales, Bird Boy, The Forgotten Children, The Boss Baby, The Breadwinner, Captain Underpants, The First Epic Movie, Cars 3, Cinderella the Cat, Coco, Despicable Me 3, Emoji Movie, Ethel and Ernest, Ferdinand, The Girl Without Hands, In This Corner of the World, The Lego Batman Movie, the Lego Ninjago Movie, Loving Vincent, Mary and the Witch's Flower. Basically, there's some of these I've actually already talked about here. Moomins in the Winter Wonderland, My Entire High School Sinking into the Sea, Napping Princess of A Silent Voice, Smurfs The Lost Village, Star, Sword Art Online, The Movie Ordinal Scale, Window, Horses The Poetic, Persian Emphasis, yeah. I can't even, like, that's actually, like, yeah. I don't even know. Yeah, I can't even pronounce that last one, so I'm not even going to bother trying. So, I would say out of the 5 that are going to get, a maximum of 5 films from the list will receive a nomination. So, I could definitely see Coco, because it's a Funimation films, not Funimation, it's Disney. So, it's Pixar. More than likely, Coco will get nominated. Maybe one of the Lego films are going to get nominated. So there's one right there. A Silent Voice, I think, has got the best potential to win. So I could definitely see that maybe getting nominated. Granted, will it win? More than likely, probably not. Probably, I mean, I could probably guarantee you, out of looking at this list, I would say probably the one that's going to win is probably going to be Coco, because it's Pixar. And let's face it, that's usually what's these Academy Award winners, these Academy Award people that have this thing, and they hate it. They just love Disney. And the fact that they go, oh, Disney, okay, let's give it to Disney. Even if it may not be that big of a movie. Now, granted, I could see them even probably throwing in Cars 3. Cars 3 wasn't really that good. But I could see them, you know, going, oh, 2 things from Disney. Okay, throw Disney in. But really, truly, I would say it's very weak. Most of these films, I would say for the most part, are very, very weak. Very weak year. Now, granted, the 2 Lego movies could make it in easily, too. So it really depends. A Silent Voice, I think, has a really good shot. I think it has the best potential out of everything to even maybe come up with an interesting upset win on this thing right here. Sword Art Online, I doubt it. Ordinal Scale, I just really doubt that that's going to be able to make any headway in it. Now, granted, as I said, I think A Silent Voice has probably got the best shot of winning. Now, granted, I don't know what you guys think is got the best shot of winning, but my thinking on it and the way it's been like for the past few years and everything else, it's probably going to be Coco. I've not yet seen Coco, but because it's Pixar and it looks really good, I'm feeling they're just going to go with that. They're going to go with the nice choice on that one. So unfortunately, we might not see another anime get nominated unless it's a Studio Ghibli film, then maybe. But I don't think there's actually much for Studio Ghibli, actually. I'm not sure. So just looking at some of the spoilers there to see if there was Studio Ghibli or not, but yeah. So I don't know. I mean, this could become a very interesting, very kind of interesting thing here to see here. But with that being said, guys, I think that's it. I think that's pretty much it right here. excuse me. So with that being said, guys, thank you so much for watching. And if there's anything else that you guys want to see us cover more in depth on this on the podcast than anything else, let us know in the comments below. Let us know what you guys want to see us do a little bit more, because I know next week is going to be, we're going to be at the convention. I'm going to try to pop one of these out of here during the convention, so definitely check it out. We're going to try to get this up as quickly as possible next week as well. So if you guys like this, make sure to give it a like and, you know, subscribe, all that fun stuff on YouTube and everything else. So with that being said, guys, thank you so much for watching. And as always, I'm Zain, and I'll see you guys on the flip side.